Many thanks for joining us. You're definitely watching Parastatal TV, the station that promotes the role of state cooperation, and I am your host, PK Wanjiro. This is Frontline. Today we are privileged to be hosting the Chief Executive Officer of Menta SACCO. Now, Menta SACCO Society Limited is a modern, fast-growing financial institution in the country. It was established way back in 1977 as Moranga Teachers Savings and Credit Society. Now, initially, it was basically to serve teachers in Moranga District, but the membership has, however, been diversified to include other areas as well. To help us understand better about Menta SACCO Society is none other than Mr. Charles A.K. Irongo, who is the Chief Executive Officer. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much.
Let's begin by first introducing to our viewers who is Menta SACCO Society Limited.
Menta SACCO Society, it's a savings and credit cooperative society based in Moranga Town, serving members in the Republic of Kenya.
Yes.
And as you are very much aware, currently we are serving teachers and members from other departments within Moranga and within the Republic of Kenya. Yes.
All right, what prompted you probably to enter in your line of business?
Initially, our organization was a teacher-based organization, and it was only offering services of savings.
Yes.
But thereafter, due to competition in the world, we decided to be offering our members simple financial services. And that is now when the organization was started the back of the front office. So now we are offering services in the back office and in the front office. Yes, yeah, yes.
All right, and probably what services are offered in the SACCO that makes it unique?
One of the most important services which we offer to our members is the loaning. That is offering them credit facilities.
Yes.
Then we also encourage them to accumulate their savings, mobilize their savings, that is.
And probably what are the benefits? For instance, somebody who's watching and they might be interested in joining the SACCO, what are some of the benefits?
Okay, once they accumulate their savings, at the end of the year or after our financial year, we offer them very high returns, that is dividends and interest on their savings. At the same time, once they accumulate their savings, we offer them credit facilities at a lower interest compared to other financial institutions. Yes.
Well, probably if you can give us the figures, what's your interest rate?
Our interest rate is at least 6.5% per annum.
Okay.
Yes.
And probably you say that you give your members very high dividends.
Yes.
Can you give us probably the numbers? What's the highest dividends that you've probably paid out before?
In fact, in 2015, in the year 2015, we managed to pay a category of Mazao shares at a rate of 13.7%.
Wow. That's 13.7%. So why is it important for the public to bank with Menta SACCO? Because I understand there are so many other SACCOs out there. Why is it important? Probably, how can you convince me to join Menta SACCO?
Okay, the reason why we should convince you to join Menta SACCO is that once you join Menta SACCO, we are able to understand your financial problems, and we can be able to advise you even where to invest, and also how to handle your finances. So people from different categories, that is the business community, the civil servants, we are able to advise them very well how to handle their finances. And with that one, they are able to handle their problems. For example, they are able to invest, they are able to educate their children, they are also able to had any financial institution which come across in their day-to-day life. Yes.
And probably how much should somebody, maybe a client who's interested, what's the minimum that that is required to be contributed probably monthly?
We start with at least only 500 shillings. If one is able to raise 500 shillings a month, we can be able to accommodate him or her, and we continue with that trade. Yes.
And I would also want to know, because you say that you give out loans.
Yes.
Supposedly, I joined today.
Yeah.
After how long am I qualified to access a loan from your facility?
It depends with the customer, the need of the customer, because maybe you can even join Mentor today, but depending with the transactions you are handling. For example, a business person.
Yes.
One might be in need of money, maybe to promote the business or to improve the business status. So once we understand the operations of that person, we can be able to loan him or her. Yeah, provided we have researched and also seen that that person is in a position of repaying that loan. Yes.
And what if they default? What are the consequences? Probably, has that happened before?
Actually, for the defaulters, we try to first of all start loaning a person with at least a low amount of money, not the huge amount of money, because you see people get inside when they get huge amounts of money.
Yes.
So when one is repaying that loan, we are able to understand the character of that person. Yes. Yeah, so we can be able to know the financial discipline of that customer. Yes, and with the time we continue advising the person. So after that, we keep on adding the amount of money which one can be loaned. Yeah. So first of all, the most important thing is to understand the customer.
Yes.
Yes.
And I'll want to know, what's your measuring stick in terms of financial discipline? How are you able to weigh that? Is it in terms of the frequency of withdrawing?
Yeah, one of the most important thing is, one, you know, you get the transactions from that customer, the deposits, the withdrawals. With that one, you can tell the character of a person. As far as finances are concerned, and at the same time, the frequency of borrowing.
Okay.
Yes.
And what's the maximum of repaying a loan? Supposedly, I qualify for a loan, or does it depend with the agreement that I have with your institution?
We have loans or credit facilities starting from 6 months to 72 months.
Okay.
Yes.
Definitely, I'm sure in your line of business, there are challenges. Kindly make us understand, what are some of the challenges, starting with the biggest to the least?
One of the most crucial challenges is the demand.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, to meet the demand of the customers.
Mm-hmm.
Because each and every person within the world is in need of money.
Oh, so definitely, how many, like, what's your clientele base? How many customers are we looking at here?
Right now, we are serving about 18,000 members.
18,000 members.
Yes.
That's a good number. And you have how many branches?
We have three main branches.
Uh-huh.
That is Muranga being the headquarter.
Uh-huh.
We have a branch at Keno. And we also have a branch at Nairobi,
mm-hmm.
within Gala area.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
There's somebody who's watching this at home, and they are asking, is it a must that I come from Muranga County for me to be a member of Mentor Circle?
No.
Mm-hmm.
We are serving members from the Republic of Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And do you have maybe plans of one day maybe becoming a fully fledged bank?
No, you'd like to be identified as a savings and credit cooperative society.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have no intentions of becoming a bank.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. In case you're joining us, with me today is the Chief Executive Officer of Mentor Circle. That is Mr. Charles A.K. Irongo. It's very easy for you to join Mentor Circle. So probably if you're looking for a savings society that can be able to build you something, that you're looking for a society that can be able to help you financially, look no further than Mentor Circle. We take a short break, but don't you touch that dial. We'll be back in just a short while.